Ah, Dublin's first city. Where else would you want to be on St. Patrick's Day? And the Irish have turned out in their thousands to watch the parade. Any vantage point will do. Even if you can't see what's going on, you're there and that's what really counts. Seems half of Dublin are watching the parade and the other half, well, they're in it, as are many countries who are represented here. Most of the major companies in Ireland enter a float, which can take months to build. Steady, girls? Flags from the nations of the world. One thing that's always represented very well at the St. Patrick's Day Parade is the national drink, the stout. The Beamish and Guinness and Murphy's. Well, I'm sure a lot of them will be gone before the end of the evening. Green and white, the order of the day. Well, I don't know who he is. Have to do some research into that. That's the Guinness lot. It's an American type band, but there's quite a few Americans over here, so it surprised me if they are American. I know there's one very good rock and roll brass band coming up later on. Best way to travel. There's somebody under there. I wasn't here. Have a chat, go on. It's America through the ages. From the space to the frontier days. Let's have another chat. Coco the Clown. It's McDonald's. There we go, lads. Can you see everything from there? Look at this crowd, isn't it wonderful? And the vantage point. Get up there and have a look. Good fun. Right, let's go and see what's happening. This is a band from Chicago, Illinois. There's about 60 of them, and they're making one hell of a sound.
Thank you. Peter.
Tony Murray, nice to meet you.
Tony, it's very pleasure.
Can we have a few words with you?
Can indeed,
yeah. I see out here on the outside, it was James Joyce and Ulysses written on the outside. What's that all about then?
Well, James Joyce, many, many moons ago, a little bit before my time now, but he did frequent the premises, and he used, as we call it, the jockey's room outside, and he did most of his writings out there. As I say, he did, and he's had his little whiskies out in the back room. Lovely man, I never met him, actually. I never actually met him, but as I say, a little bit before my time. But that was his little haunt outside. He used to go into the back room there, do his little bit of writing, and have his few jars.
How long have you been here?
I'm drinking in the shop, I think, 32 years.
So you must have seen, because the Theatre Royal was across the road, you must have seen a lot of faces then.
It was absolutely superb. I mean, we've had more theatre people coming in here. You had the likes of Snozzles Durante, you had Roy Rogers, Gene Autry, Jimmy Campbell, of course, who was the leader of the orchestra across the way. He was a great regular here. We've had, I mean, the people that, we had actually President Kennedy come in here.
Did he?
He did indeed. He did.
So that's what happened to him, was it?
That's what happened to him. He got a bad drink. Yes,
well,
we have.
I've had a pint of Guinness in here, and it's wonderful. I'm going to have another one as well. So
I'll tell you one thing, you couldn't get a better pint of Guinness in the city. This is the best house in Dublin for a pint of Guinness. And a very popular house. Very popular.
Well, you can see by the amount of people in here.
Indeed.
Your shamrock is beginning to wilt a bit now.
It's going now. It's out of the water for a long time.
I think you're going to need a few more of them just to get it going.
I think I've got another few pints, I think, if possibly.
Thanks very much for talking.
Indeed, a great pleasure, and a very happy Patrick's Day to you. Lovely, lovely.
Well, you may wonder what we're doing in the rain on a Sunday afternoon at Camberley. And it's pouring a rain here. What we're actually doing is watching lots of people in cowboy hats and cowboy boots doing things called step dancing, all that sort of stuff, because it's the annual British Country Music Radio Awards. So we're going to go inside and find a lovely way to spend a Sunday afternoon. It's bucketing down, so just follow me. And in here, through these doors, is a scene I'd never thought I'd see on a wet Sunday afternoon in England. America, Nashville, maybe, yes, but not particularly here. There's a bunch of happy people on the door. And here we are. Becky, the Haleys,
yes.
Welcome to the Lakeside Country Club.
Thank you.
Great set we just seen.
Thank you very much.
How long have you been going in country music?
We've been going about 5 years now. Yeah, just 5 years. We started in 1990, so it's just 5 years.
Mm-hmm. That's a great accent. Where are you from?
Bradford. West Yorkshire.
Fantastic. So what got you into country music?
My parents, really. They used to sing it when we were younger, and they used to play country records all the time, so... Hello Harris, and
listen to it,
she
so
was our biggest
listen to it so much you just had to like it in the end.
So this is the award ceremony this afternoon. Have you won any awards on this one, or you won ones in the past?
We won last year,
didn't we? Yeah.
The best British album.
Yeah.
But you can't win every year, can you?
No.
You've got to give other people a chance, haven't you?
That's right. So what sort of music do you like? I mean, do you like the new country rock?
Yeah, love it.
We try and do more of.
It's been a shot in the arm, really, for country music, hasn't it?
Yeah.
And everybody goes on about Dolly Parton and everybody. But now you've got your Garth Brooks and your Dwight Yoakams.
CMT's doing.
Where are you going with your country music? Are you sort of crossing over into more like rock or what? Are you going?
Some of the ballads we do, they're kind of like rock, a bit rocky, like rock ballads. Yeah. But still got a country feel there, you know.
Yeah. Just get some distortion on the lead.
Yeah.
That's right. We're here at the Lakeside this afternoon. Great venue, isn't it?
It's
fantastic.
Yeah, it's
but the people are great, too. This is the whole thing about it. You've got a whole age group from youngsters up to, you know. And I've seen 70-year-olds there in Stetsons jumping up. But it's great. It's a great crossover, and people love it, don't they?
It's a lovely atmosphere.
It's good. We've enjoyed it.
So, are you recording at the moment?
We've just finished recording in Nashville, actually.
In Nashville?
Yeah.
Go on, tell us about it, then. We'll know all about Nashville. Go on.
It's all original.
No, it's all, the album's album. all original songs. And we picked like different styles, like waltzes and ballads and up-tempo numbers. And Nashville's really good. If you ever get to go to the Grand Old Opry in the Rockland.
Yeah, what's that like? I've heard a lot about it.
It's brilliant. Really nice. Yeah,
we had indoor gardens.
Yeah, we had a backstage pass to the Grand Old Opry, and it was brilliant experience, wasn't it?
You get to meet all the stars.
Yeah. Well, you'll be up there one day, singing away.
Oh, no.
Yeah. What do you do? Pick up session musicians there when you're recording or what?
Well, we took our band over to do the album, Rosie on drums and Brian on the guitar.
Yeah. Give them a big plug because they were great this afternoon.
They were brilliant. We got an extra keyboard player who was absolutely excellent, and harmonica, steel, fiddle, you know.
Yeah.
Yeah, so we did have extra musicians.
Yeah.
Okay. It came out really well, though.
Fantastic. So when are we going to get a copy of this?
March 16th. Yeah.
Okay, well, maybe we'll play a few clips on the show.
Thank you.
Well, thanks for talking to us.
Thank you.
And thanks for coming down to the website.
Thank you.
Pleasure.
Okay,
thank you very much.
Bye. The nominations here. If you're not clear, I'll read them out again. I'm not going to take too much time. The best album by a British act recorded anywhere. Nominations are Web of Love, Sarah Jory. 16 Country Favourites, Volume 2, Jerry Ford. Jerry's an old friend of mine, another ex-policeman. And live at Montreux, Albert Lee and Hogan's Heroes at Round Tower. And the winner, and a lot of silence for this, want to build up the tension. Web of Love, Sarah Jory!
Just about to go on.
Let me
clean up.
I know. I can't believe it. I really can't. I feel very, very humble.
What are you doing with this award? Where are you going to put it?
That actually makes 98 that I've won over the last. I won my first award when I was 11, so and I'm now 25. So that's over the last 14 years. I actually started playing in bands when I was 9 years old on the pedal steel guitar, but I've been fronting and singing and leading my own band for the last 5.5 years. I grew up listening to Patsy Cline and Jim Reeves and Hank Williams, so that's really where my roots are. I certainly think that country music in this country is on the up and up. From the amount of coverage my last album had and the shows are getting, it seems to be improving. People are starting to take us seriously. I suppose I am so-called new wave, because we do a lot of progressive country, but we still do a lot of the traditional tunes as well, because I don't believe in sweeping those under the carpet.
So what's your audience age group?
Really, as young as 5 and 6 years old, right up to grannies and granddads, you know, we seem to appeal to a very wide range, which was something that I wasn't sure at the start whether we were going to or not. You know, I thought, I hope I don't alienate one section or another. She's going to pop music or she's leaving country behind, but Obviously not.
Best
album of the year, recorded anywhere by a British artist, and most nominated artist.
Great. Well, you're on in about 2 minutes, actually.
Yes,
so we better
we
hold
are.
You up.
Okay.
All the people waiting. Best
Thank you very
luck.
Much.
Fantastic achievement. Three awards.
Thank you very much
okay.
indeed.
Thanks for talking to us.
Thank you, and enjoy
okay.
the show.
Yeah, we'll do.
Okay,
you.
Bye-bye.
Okay, bye. Ladies and gentlemen, please welcome on stage Red's recording star, Miss Sarah Jory.
The one and only one, quality range and service to tons. For carpets, every style and size, the finest place around.
Fitting,
dust-free,
estimates,
delivery. We'll make sure that carpet's right for you. For higher standards and lower prices. Downs of Newbury. Downs of Newbury.
Stop for fast photo service at Photostop Express. Photostop.
Your local Photostop Express store is at Cooper's the Chemist, High Street, Andover. We offer a 1 hour photo service which includes a free film, this is worth £2.69. And a free mounted enlargement worth £2.49. Total value of free goods is £5.18. For the best value in town, drop down to the Photostop Express store at Cooper the Chemist.
Photostop Express!
Well,
Well, I'm in Winchester Street at the moment. A lot of friends of mine have been talking about the Eastern Eye Indian restaurant, and I came down to find out what they're all raving about, and I've found out. Now, I had a chicken tina boona. I think that's what it's called. We'll find out in a minute if my pronunciation is right, but it was really delicious. And I'm going to talk to Ali, who's been here for a year now, and as far as I know, business is booming. How is business, Ali?
Business is okay.
If I wanted to get something stronger than the chicken tikka boona, did I say that right? What scale will I go on from there?
I mean, depends how hot you want. You can have a Madras, which is fairly hot, a bit hotter than just chicken tikka boona you had. And if you want more hotter, you go for chicken vindaloo.
Now that's quite blow your socks off time, isn't it?
Depends how hot you eat, yes.
What is the most popular strength that you serve here?
Most popular strength served is chicken tikka masala, which is sweet, mild, and I think everybody likes mild. And it's your own choice, what do you like best.
And what is the strongest possible curry you can get?
You can get a chicken fowl or meat fowl, which is really hot and it will blow your head.
Does anybody ever order that?
Yes, there is few people order that and they enjoy it.
Well, I bet they need a few pints of lager after that.
Not necessarily. If you're used to having a hot curries, then you don't. But you, before you come to India, you always have a few pints in it.
Before you come?
And if you're in a really hot curry, you always think of lager or cold drinks, which is to cool you down. But sometimes it doesn't work.
But I've been recommended at one stage when I had a really hot curry that to take a slice of lemon, that cools you down.
It does, yes, it's true.
Oh, it does actually work.
It does work, yes.
I think I'll go for the pint of lager anyway.
It's up to you. But the best cure of hot is the hot water or tea.
Hot water?
Yeah, it just cools it straight away. It burns you out, but it cools you straight away.
How many staff have you got working here with your mum?
I mean, we are 6 in here. But we full times is 4 of us and 2 are part times.
And you also serve Indian lager as well. Everything is
Indian lagers, yes. Yes, and that's a bit strong. And I think quite few people likes it.
It's strong?
Yeah, it's strong lager.
Like the fowl.
Like the fowl, yeah.
What's happening here for Easter? Have you got anything special happening?
Yes, we are doing a set meal for 2 people. That is, you can have a meat dish or a vegetable dish, which is comes with starter, main meal, dessert, coffee, and a bottle of wine with it.
And this will run for quite a while then?
It will run for Easter months.
I've got a great idea. You know this competition we're doing on our show every week, and thanks very much for all your phone calls because the response has been great to these things. I was just going to ask Ali to try and get something out of him. Ali, is there any chance of you doing a competition with a meal for 2?
I mean, yes, we would be happy to do something like that because we haven't done anything like this for last whole year we've been here. And we will do it, okay?
That's wonderful. So don't forget to look out for the competition. And Ali, bless him, said that he will welcome 2 people here and you get one of these delicious meals with a bottle of wine as well. So wait for the competition and I'll ask Ali. He's going to set the question and watch out for that. Ali, thanks for talking to us today.
It's nice to talk to you, Tony. Thank you.
We're on the wall with the state. Did you know that there's a brewer up here in the wall with the state? Well, I didn't know until recently, although I saw it in one of the pubs around town. I think there's quite a few of them. But Shawn Matthews here is one of the partners in the business. And, well, works here. I'm not quite sure what he is yet. But we'll find out. Shawn, how are you? It's nice to meet you.
Pleased to meet you.
Is there any chance of you showing us around and see what happens inside?
Certainly.
That's great stuff. Can we go in? Lovely smell of yeast in here now. You all right, Steve? Right, oh, this is lovely, isn't it? A wooden cast. Is it always in wood or is it in steel?
It's stainless steel tanks, but
we've actually clad them in wood to give the smart appearance.
Yeah, it looks really nice. How long have you been here now?
The actual brewery's been running now for 18 months.
And how's business?
Booming.
Excellent. So people are still drinking?
Very much so.
Right. This started off, I believe, as a hobby. So who else is in the business with you?
There's Philip and Leslie Newton. They're the owners of the brewery. And yes, as you say, Philip started off as a hobby years ago and transferred it to the brewery as you see it now.
So what sort of barrelage would you get out of here? I mean, points-wise or barrels, however it works.
We're brewing, these particular vessels are five-barrel vessels. That's 4 9-gallon firkins to a barrel. These, the new 7.5-barrel plants we're just installing now. This one's now online. And we have one more to come in later in the year.
How many different brews do you do?
We're doing three at the moment, Anna Valley, Bawkesbury Bitter and Clatford Clout. We've got a new one coming online very shortly called Old Hatch Ale.
Is that going to be a strong one?
That's a
6%.
6%? That's right.
Knock your socks off again.
It will. That was actually at the Andover Beer X this year and the Basingstoke on trial.
Yeah, but we were down last week. I wasn't here, but the other lads came down. Steve, you were down there, Steve, weren't you? At the beer festival. It seemed to go extremely well. You were down there also.
Yes, we were.
Had tastings.
Very good tastings.
Right. Now, can you tell the viewers how this works? I mean, what happens? How does the whole process work?
Right, we'll start from upstairs if we can.
Can you get up here? There's a bit of a squeeze.
Right, this is the hot liquor tank. So we're not allowed to call it water. It's liquor for brewing. So we start off with the liquor here at the required temperature. We then have a hopper where the malt is kept. It's then fed into a mash tun and mixed with water and left to stew for an hour and a half. Then it's sparged through the arms, again water from here, and dropped down into the copper.
So that's gravity down into this?
Gravity fed into the copper, yes.
Right, we've got to go down the stairs again.
Back down again.
Right then, Steve. I'll watch you. Right, we're downstairs now, and the gravity takes it down to here, and what happens in this one?
That's right. We collect the wort into the copper, where it's boiled to a temperature of 100 degrees, and mixed with hops for the flavour.
How long will it stay in this container here?
That will boil for just over the hour, and then it's taken from the copper through the system here, through a paraflow system, into a fermenter. And it's taken at 100 degrees in the copper and cooled down via there to 20 degrees in a matter of seconds.
And it stays here for how long?
There it'll stay for 3-4 days to let the yeast work its way and turn all our nice little sugars into alcohol, and then transferred into our smaller tanks behind you for conditioning.
So I see, this conditions everything here, so you've got the three different ales in it.
That's right, yes, they're conditioning here for approximately a week and then barreled up and sold.
What is the sales like locally? Have you got many outlets for it?
Currently we're operating about 20.
20?
Accounts, yeah.
That's excellent, isn't
it's
it?
Very good news. Yes.
Sean, there's some awards here. What's this thirsty tour for a start?
We did that beer as a special for the Tour de France that came through Andover. And we've been asked to brew it again.
Well, the boys didn't stop on their bikes and get off and have a pint in.
We tried.
You got other awards here. What are these awards for?
We won these at the Basingstoke Beer Festival for the Clatford Clout last year. Best beer of its class and best overall beer of the exhibition. And we won it again this year as well, both awards.
So there's 2 years running you won these?
That's right, for the same beer.
Oh, that's excellent, isn't it?
That's good, pleasing. Good beer.
Right. A cup. What's the cup for?
Our little trophy. That's the Test Valley and Bloom Award for being a green brewery.
And what does that mean?
Our hops and malt are recycled. They're sent to a local farmer who mixes them with milk and feeds them to his animals. And we recycle our water. It's brought back from the copper, which we saw earlier,
and put back into the tank for the next day's brewing.
Well, that's excellent, so you're not wasting anything at all.
We don't waste a thing.
Well done. Shawn, thanks very much for having us here today.
Thank you very much for coming.
And we'll have a taste somewhere.
We will indeed.
Right, we've seen the brewery, we've seen how this beer is made. The proof of the pudding is to taste it, so we've come over to the Crook and Shears in Clafford, and we're going to talk to the landlord here, who's Rob Rees. Rob, how are you?
Very well, Tony. Yeah, how yourself?
Very good indeed. How's business here?
Pretty good. Don't want to say too much, but, you know, keeping the wool from the dog and pay the rent, so it's that's a good start, isn't it?
The main part. How's Clafford Clout doing for you?
Excellent. We've had the Clout year for approximately 2 years now, since Phil first brewed it. In fact, we had the world premiere, would you believe, of the Clafford Clout at the Crook and Shears, and we had the camera people up for that day, and it's been a regular feature here ever since, along with Phil's other beers.
Yeah, these Clafford Clout, did they name it just because for this pub? What was the name? What was the reason for Clafford?
I think it was because Phil and Leslie live in Anna Valley, and they have three beers, again, with local names, all with local names, Anna Valley Ale, Borksbury Bitter, and of course Clafford Clout being the top of the range, their premier brew. So, you know, it is definitely a good seller.
I'm going to try one in a minute, but before I do, I still need to be able to talk, which I can't do very well at the moment. How long have you been here then, Rob?
Just over 2 years, and yeah, new to the trade, and things are okay, yeah.
Oh, this is your first time in the trade?
Yeah, seasoned professional now, 2 years in, and quite enjoying it, I must say.
Did you have to do a course before you got here for this?
Yes, we're affiliated with Whitbread, so we actually own the freehold of the building, even though we've acquired you know, 20-year lease. And they insist that you've got a 2-week training course, which is good fun, and definitely assists in you know, getting yourself into the trade on the proper footing.
Right, now you know where to come for Clafford Clout. We're in the Crook and Shears, and I'm going to try one now. Do you think I might have one then, Ron?
All right then, Tony, yes. Have this on the house, how's that?
That's even better. Well, the Guinness was very nice. That was last week, St. Patrick's Day, and this looks excellent, so I'm just going to have a taste of it. Oh, that's really good.
When you're ready.
Take it away, Martin.
Lisa
we got a letter last week from Jo Lawrence. She's somewhere around. And she, there she is. Where is she? There she is. And she said there was a band up in Harroway School that we ought to come up and have a look at, because her brother's in it, see? And he plays bass guitar, and he's, where is he? Where is he? He's over there. There he is. So we came up to have a listen, and we really are impressed. It's a very, very good band, and they're going to do a lot of good things here. So what we first do is find out who they are. So I'm going to run around, and if you can do it quickly, give me your names.
Jimmy. Luke.
Luther.
Chris.
Martin.
Stephen.
Sarah.
Dan.
Rebecca.
Rebecca, if you didn't hear that one. Who started this band? Luther. How long ago was this, Luther, you started?
Well, I was in a band about 3 years ago, and that split up, so I wanted to create another one. So I got a couple of my friends together, and that's how it started.
How long ago was that?
About 3 years.
3 years. And most of the material you do is your own. Who does the writing?
I write them, and so does Luke.
Luke, you're the other lead singer, so you've got two lead singers.
Yeah, me and Leifer, co-singers, yeah.
And the rest of the lineup, what's that?
The rest of the lineup is we've got Jimmy plays bass. Yeah. We have two backing singers, Sarah and Becca. We have a lead guitar, Daniel Sorensen. We have keyboards, Chrissy Andrews. Martin Morris on the rhythm. Stephen on drums. And that's our lineup,
really. Right, I heard you did a gig. How did that go?
Our first gig, yeah. It went quite well, actually. Yeah, we were packed out. And we earned some money for comic relief, which was good.
Oh, excellent. Good cause as well. You're thinking about recording at the moment, aren't you? Are you in the middle of recording at the moment?
Yeah, we're in the middle of recording at the moment. Saturday, we recorded three songs. And after we've done that, we'll take them to radio stations and stuff like that.
Record companies and...
Yep, and hopefully, we don't know.
Well, I mean, the Troggs started doing about this age as well. You wouldn't believe it. They're so old now. Not me. Forgot the hair dye today. But they went on to better things, and they're doing a lot of good things now, so I can see you guys doing. Are you going to stick together?
Yes.
Yeah, definitely.
You are?
Yeah, definitely.
Have you got any other gigs lined up?
In July we should be playing for the rest of the school.
Harroway Hall.
About 200 people in there we can, so...
Oh, that'd be fantastic. I mean, this is really good. What we saw today was excellent. What we'd have to do is come back and, when they've done the demo and that, we'd come back and have a listen to some more songs that they've done. So for the moment, keep your eye out for EKLIPSE. I can't get up.
Well, we told you we'd come to see the Troggs on tour, and here we are backstage at the Anvil. And there's one of the stars of our show, Peter Noone, just walking past, and there's the Troggs dressing room. I don't know what they're doing in there, but we're going to see who else we can find. We'll speak to Peter in a minute. Peter Noone, Herman's Hermits, and all that sort of stuff. There we are, Freddie. That's Freddie and the Dreamers. They're all here tonight. Actually, Wayne Fontana's on stage. Remember Wayne Fontana? All those songs. And down here, oh, we got the Beverly Brothers. I don't know who the Beverly Brothers are, but I think they're probably the backing band. But anyway, great tour tonight. So if it's not the Beverly Brothers, it must be Wayne Fontana. But anyway, we'll see you on stage, and then we'll do a few interviews behind these doors. Right, Reg, welcome to Basingstoke after this arduous tour. What are you, halfway through the tour?
So halfway through. It feels like 7 years, actually, at this present time, yeah.
What's it like being on the road this length of time, though, really?
Well, it takes it out of you, you know. I mean, we haven't worked like this since 66, you know, but it's good. When you get in the swing of it, it goes along pretty well.
It keeps you fit. It was a great performance we saw just now. Absolutely fantastic. But how do you feel? Somebody, a little birdie tells me you're not very well.
No, we went out for a meal and it looks as though we've caught salmonella or whatever it is. Yeah.
Food poisoning.
Food poisoning, yeah. And we're suffering very, very bad with it. We can't eat. And then they reckon it's going to be with us. The doctor reckoned today it's going to be with us for another 10 days at least. So at the moment I feel really drained, you know, with one thing and another, but hopefully 10 days time we'll be sparkling again.
Now, what's this rumour about the Manchester bands hating the Troggs? I mean, all these Hampshire and Wiltshire boys, they don't like them very much. They say they're all from Manchester.
Yeah, I know, but I mean, you've got to expect that. Anything north of Oxford is, yeah.
You just can't get the bands these days, can you?
That's really,
How's the UFOs going? Just a quick plug for that.
Very good. It looks as though things are starting to happen now on the old Roswell front. We shall see very soon. There's a lot of TV coverage and newspaper coverage on it. So we are hoping that something will develop, you know.
We've got a big channel in America who wants to do the UFO show. That's quite good news as well.
Yeah, that's very good news, yeah. As soon as we get this tour over with, we can start into that. Maybe the old Andover viewers will see some of it as well.
Yeah. We just interviewed Ken Dyke. Ken Dyke from the Advertiser is a big fan of yours. He's come all the way up from Andover to watch you tonight. So.
All right. Great one.
Anyway, we also dragged you out, Reg, to do a little competition. We've been running competitions every week with great success. And this one is a meal for two at the Buddha, and we've had loads of correct entries. These are the winners in here. Well, they made the final round. And if you wouldn't mind putting your hand in there, just drawing out one ticket, and those people...
There you go. This has got to be the lucky one. Simon Hewitt. Yes.
Simon Hewitt. There we are, Simon. You won the meal for two at the Buddha, so that's pretty good. But we'll ring you and let you know when you can go up there.
When we're fitting well, we'd like to join you for this meal, because we haven't been able to eat for about 4 days now.
Okay, well, I'm sure it's going to be great at the Buddha. Anyway, thanks for talking to us. Where are you tomorrow night?
Bournemouth, the BIC at Bournemouth, yeah.
If it's Thursday, it must be Basingstoke. It's a bit like doing a year. One question I asked to the other bands, if somebody offered you 150 days in America tomorrow, would you take it?
Tomorrow? Gee. I don't think so. I don't think I could take it. No, after a month off, yeah.
Okay, fantastic. And well done for Lovers All Around. Won so many awards this year and last year, so congratulations. See you again soon.
Cheers, bye.
Cheers, Reg. Well, here we are at the Anvil in the auditorium, and look who we bumped into. Do you remember on Time TV you told us was going to be here? None other than Ken Dykes from the Underwear Advertiser. Ken, welcome.
Thanks very much, Alan. Yeah, what do you think of it so far?
I think it's brilliant. We've been backstage filming a bit, interviewed Peter Noone and all those guys, and it's pretty great, I think.
I've been out front in the auditorium, absolutely brilliant so far. We said, don't miss Reg. He's been terrific, absolutely smashing.
Yeah. He's suffering from food poisoning a bit, Reg.
I'm going to say, he sounded a little bit croaky, apologised a bit. I think he's had a fairly hard tour. But there's still time to catch him. There's still, what's he doing, 60 shows in 2 months? Absolutely unbelievable.
He's touring the whole of March and April, I think. It's been quite incredible.
Does he come back to Andover every night?
I don't think so, no. So anyway, enough of Basingstoke. We're going to talk about Andover. Right. You were telling me today about the Carnival Queen and the princesses.
Yes, we've got the Carnival Princess competition fairly well on its way now. The final takes place in Flicks Nightclub on Saturday the 22nd of April. All young kids between the ages of 8 and 13 are invited to come along, join in the junior disco, win a prize, watch Andover Pickett's Carnival Princess for 1995.
You're telling me the prizes are pretty good this year too. The Round Table have been involved in this?
No, that was the Carnival Queen competition, which begins in April and runs through April and May. We look as if we might well attract a lot of girls into the Carnival Queen competition this year, because the prizes are really fantastic. In the past, it's been a little bit of a Cinderella kind of competition, but this year, the Round Table have really got their act together. As you know, they run the carnival every year in Andover for local charities, and this year, it looks as if there are going to be prizes worth well over £1,000 for the Carnival Queen and her two attendants. In fact, the Carnival Queen 1995 in Andover could be picking up prizes over £1,000 herself.
That's absolutely amazing, isn't it? And you've had all the contestants as well for the princess in the paper?
Yep, we published all their pictures. And
what's the response been like?
Tremendous. 100 contestants, and we've now reduced them to 12 finalists, and we'll be picking the winner, as I say, on the 22nd of April. But girls, you know, don't forget the Carnival Queen competition. We need all you girls to enter. The winner will be getting prizes worth something like £1,000. The prizes will be worth about £400 or £500 for the second place and £300 or £400 for the third place. There's a £300 holiday, I believe, is the first prize. plus a £200 voucher for the leisure centre, and all sorts of other prizes. Specially made dress of your choice, made to measure. That's got to be worth another couple of £100. Terrific prizes. Join the competition, watch the Andover Advertiser. In the next few weeks, we'll be giving you all the details.
Okay, fantastic. Well, thanks for talking to us. And sorry to catch you out at Basingstoke, but it's a great show, isn't it?
Don't worry about it. I'm looking forward to the second half of the show now.
Yeah, we've got Freddie and the Dreamers and Peter Noone.
Lovely, lovely, yeah.
We'll see you later, Ken. Thanks for talking to us. Cheers, bye-bye. Well, here we are. We found the winners of our competition to actually come and see the Troggs and Wayne Fontana and everybody else at the Anvil. And it's Anne. And it's Steve. How are you doing?
Not too bad.
See, if you ring up Town TV, you can win a prize, can't you?
Yes, indeed you can.
Yeah. And they let you in, there's no hassle.
No problem at all.
So who are you looking forward to seeing tonight?
Well, Reg Presley.
He's not a well man. He's got food poisoning, I must tell you that.
Oh, great.
It's true, he's been moaning and great. No, he hasn't really, but he has been moaning a bit. But he's not very well. But a very good performance in the first show.
Mm, yeah, I'm looking forward to it. It should be really good.
Freddie's totally mad, isn't he, Steve? And Wayne Fontana is great, and Peter Noone is brilliant, so...
Good. Good stuff.
Not that far, is it? There should be a place like this in Andover, really, shouldn't there?
Well, it should be, really. It's it's only a 25-minute drive, but the more you've got like this in Andover, the better.
Well, great. Thanks for entering into the spirit of the competition. Thanks for coming to Basingstoke, and enjoy the show. Okay, how are you, Mick?
Nice to see you, mate.
And who's this here?
That's my wife.
That's Valerie. And you're Valerie, right?
That's right, yeah. Okay.
Well done for winning the prize.
Yeah, thank you very much. Glad I won. Okay. Makes a change.
Viewers, if you watch the show, you'll probably see Mick rushing through the Chantry Centre, but you did really well to win. Who got the answers? Come on.
Me. She didn't know nothing about it till she got home.